There's tremendous skepticism there about China. It's viewed as a foe. It's viewed as a government that seeks to take our intellectual property, our national secrets and treasure.
The U.S. banned China from the International Space Station, but why? And what does it mean for the future of space exploration? It might seem strange today, but back in the 80s, there was a time when the US and China were working on cool space projects. Back in the day, they shared information about weather satellites and even talked about letting Chinese astronauts ride on the US space shuttle. It seemed like they could achieve amazing things together in space. However, things started to change in the 2000s. The US became worried about China getting stronger, especially its military. Imagine sharing your secrets with someone who might use those tricks to beat you. That's how the US felt about sharing its space technology. Then in 2007, China did something that really freaked the US out. They blew up one of their old satellites in space, creating a huge mess of space junk. It was like throwing a tantrum in a playground and making it unsafe for everyone else. The US got even more worried that China might use its technology to cause trouble in space. So in 2011, a US congressman named Frank Wolf basically said, "No more playing with China in space." This meant no Chinese astronauts on the International Space Station, and no more teaming up on space projects. And the major reason the US did that is because China's space program is really close with its military. In some countries, space exploration and the military are separate, but in China, they work together. This makes the US even more worried that even if something seems like it's just for science, it might actually be helping the Chinese military become stronger. So the US and China went from being space buddies to kind of like space frenemies. They're still both exploring space, but they're doing it separately and sometimes even competing with each other. Another concern is about copying. The US spends a lot of time and money creating new space technology, and they don't want China copying their inventions without asking. It's a real shame that the US and China aren't working together in space. By keeping China out of the International Space Station, scientists from both countries can't share their cool ideas or work on projects together. This is a bummer because China is really good at certain things, like figuring out how to make new materials and keeping astronauts healthy in space. Imagine if their smart scientists could team up with the ones on the space station. They might come up with amazing discoveries that help us build better spaceships or travel further into space. Plus, keeping China out of big space projects makes things harder for everyone. Exploring space is getting more and more difficult and expensive. Think about going back to the moon or even sending people to Mars. Those missions are super tough. If the smartest people in the world can't work together, it might take us way longer to achieve these awesome goals. Or maybe we won't even be able to do them at all. Space should be a place where countries forget about their differences and focus on exploring the universe together. It reminds us that we all live on the same planet and that teamwork makes the dream work. Sadly, the problems between the US and China are getting in the way of that dream. But there's still hope. History shows us that even countries that don't get along can work together in space. Remember the Cold War, when the US and the Soviet Union were like enemies? Even then, they managed to do something amazing called the Apollo-Soyuz mission, where their spaceships met up in space. It was a sign that even when countries disagree, they can still cooperate to do something bigger than themselves. If they could do it, maybe the US and China can figure out how to work together too, so everyone can benefit from exploring space. Okay, so the US might have its issues with China in space, but what about the rest of the world? First up, the European Space Agency, ESA. It turns out Europeans are a bit more open to the idea of sharing space toys with China. They see scientific potential and frankly don't always love feeling like they need to pick sides between the US and China. Don't get them wrong, they're all about the International Space Station, but they've also partnered with China on stuff like satellite missions. Over in Asia, space agencies in Japan and India are also finding ways to work with China on certain projects. It makes sense, they're neighbors in space after all. They sometimes look to collaborate on projects where their interests overlap, like Earth observation and studying our planet from above. So what's the takeaway? Let's just say the US ban isn't a universal rulebook. Other space agencies have different opinions on how much or how little to collaborate with China. While the ISS crew keeps it pretty exclusive, who knows what the future holds? Maybe someday we'll see a whole mix of astronauts from different countries all working together up there. It would seriously be out of this world. See what I did there? Okay, forget NASA and China's space agency for a moment. The real wild cards might be the private companies getting into the space game. You've got players like SpaceX and Blue Origin here in the US, and China has its own rising stars like CAS Space. Now, these companies aren't just launching rockets for fun. Well, maybe for a little fun, but they're also about business. The cool thing is, business sometimes crosses borders in a way that government stuff doesn't. Could there be secret handshake deals and partnerships happening beyond the whole US versus China space standoff? It's tricky because technology is at the heart of this, and everyone wants to protect their secrets. But hey, maybe SpaceX quietly uses a part designed in China, or CAS Space launches a satellite built with US components. Stranger things have happened. Here's the big question. Will these companies be the ones who truly shape the future of space? Think about it. Governments are slow, bound by laws and politics. Companies can be more daring, move faster, and take risks. Imagine a future where it's not just flags planted on the moon, but company logos. A SpaceX lunar base right beside a Chinese outpost? It sounds like sci-fi because it actually is. Getting shut out of the International Space Station didn't stop China. It actually made them more determined. They decided if they couldn't join the ISS, they'd make their own space station, which they called Tiangong, meaning heavenly place. It's a huge project, and they've been launching pieces of it into space for a few years now. Soon, they'll have a space station just as impressive as the ISS, and they did it all by themselves. This shows that being left out actually made China's space program stronger and more independent, not weaker like the US might have thought. The ban hasn't just made China go its own way, it's also changed how the US and China act in space. Instead of working together, they're starting to act more like rivals, like two teams always competing against each other. This space race is happening in different areas. Both the US and China want to go back to the moon and are trying to get there first. They're also competing to have the best satellite technology so they can communicate and see Earth better from space. Even companies in both countries are racing to see who can launch rockets cheaper or offer space tourism first. Sadly, the competition is causing problems with other countries involved in the International Space Station. Some countries, like those in Europe, are more open to working with China on space projects. they don't like feeling like they have to choose sides between US and China because of the ban. They could cause arguments between the space station partners, which isn't good for working together peacefully in space. Okay, imagine for a second. No Wolf Amendment, no awkward, you can't come to my space party situations. Instead, imagine brilliant American and Chinese scientists brainstorming together aboard the International Space Station. They're sharing ideas, combining strengths, and pushing the boundaries of what we thought possible. So what could they have achieved? Maybe up there, floating in zero gravity, they discover a way to manufacture super strong, super light materials that revolutionize how we build things. Not just spacecrafts, but planes, buildings, or kitchen tops. Everything. Or picture them studying how the human body reacts to long-term spaceflight, cracking the code on how to keep astronauts healthy enough to reach Mars way sooner than we ever planned. Let's go even bolder. Forget the moon, forget Mars. How about a joint US-China mission to explore the icy moons of Jupiter? Think Europa, where there might be an ocean of water hidden beneath the surface. This could be the place we finally find alien life. With both nations pooling their resources and knowledge, the mission could have telescopes, probes, maybe even submarines designed to explore that mysterious underwater world. Of course, it's easy to dream, and who knows if any of this would have definitely happened, but the possibility, the what if, is what stings a little, isn't it? It makes you wonder how much faster, how much further we could have gone if some of the brightest minds on the planet were allowed to work hand in hand. So as you can see, the relationship between the US and China is complicated. It's a mix of competition, mistrust, and missed opportunities. What do you think the future holds for these two space giants? Will they find a way to work together, or will the space race continue to heat up? And if you've enjoyed this video, check out this next one.